solemnity of the Ascension of the Lord. This is the seventh Sunday of Easter. Today we have the great delight of initiating an adult into the church with the sacraments of baptism, confirmation, and Eucharist. Nicole was originally scheduled for her initiation at the Easter Vigil, but because of COVID in her family, we had to delay until today. And so that's a great delight to be able to celebrate with all of you her full initiation into the faith. Even though the CDC and the state of Michigan have said we don't have to wear masks, the Archdiocese of Detroit has asked us to continue to wear masks at least through this weekend, and they'll get back to us during the week for clarification regarding next weekend's celebration of Pentecost. I see most of you are wearing your masks. I think all of you are wearing your masks, but I deeply appreciate your request and fulfillment of their request by keeping as safe as possible during this incredibly strange and now very confusing time for all of us. Let's stand and join our gathering song as we celebrate the solemnity of the Lord.
Thank you.
Almighty God, gladden us with holy joy, and make us rejoice with devout thanksgiving at the ascension of Christ your Son. For it is our exaltation, where the head has gone before in glory, the body is called to follow in hope. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Today we return to the opening verses of the Acts of the Apostles. Here the author, Luke, sets forth ideas that he will develop throughout the rest of the book. The major theme is the power and motivation, the work of the Holy Spirit in the church.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I dealt with all that Jesus did and taught until the day he was taken up, after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. He presented himself alive to them by many proofs after he had suffered, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, about which you have heard me speak. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized by the Holy Spirit. When they had gathered together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He answered them, it is not for you to know the times or seasons that the Father has established by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were looking on, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him from their sight. While they were looking intently at the sky as he was going, suddenly two men, dressed in white garments, stood beside them. They said, Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking at the sky? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will return in the same way as you have seen him going to heaven. Word of the Lord.
A proclamation of Psalm 47.
Thank you.
city located on the western shore of what is now the country of Turkey. Today's passage is near the beginning of the letter to this Christian community, and it is a prayer asking God's blessing upon the church.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, may the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation, resulting in knowledge of Him. May the eyes of your hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to His call. What are the riches of glory in His inheritance among the holy ones? And what is the surprising greatness of His power for those who believe, in accord with the exercise of His great might, which He worked in Christ, raising Him from the dead and seating Him at His right hand in the heavens. Far above every principality, authority, power, and dominion, and every name that is named not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And He put all things beneath His feet and gave Him as head over all things to the church, which is His body, the fullness of the one who fills all things in every way. The word of the Lord.
These signs will accompany those who believe. In my name, they will drive out demons. They will speak new languages. They will pick up serpents with their hands. And if they drink any deadly thing, it will not harm them. They will lay hands on the sick, and they will recover. So then, the Lord Jesus, after he spoke to them, was taken up to heaven and took his seat at the right hand of God the Father. But they went forth and preached everywhere, while the Lord worked with them and confirmed their words through accompanying signs. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you. Today, as we celebrate the Ascension of the Lord, we keep in mind the necessity of going up in order to get to paradise. Throughout this Easter season, you've heard the phrase, the Paschal Mystery. The Paschal Mystery is what we celebrate throughout this Easter season. It's not only the resurrection of the Lord. It's his suffering, which we call his passion, his death on the cross, his resurrection from the dead 3 days later, and now that Paschal mystery comes to its completion today as we celebrate his ascension, which is said to have occurred 40 days after his resurrection, during which time he continued to teach his disciples. And as we heard in today's gospel, he sends them forth on mission. But he himself is raised and takes his place at the right hand of God the Father. Why is that where he takes his seat? Well, you know how royalty works, don't you? You've seen stories, movies of royalty. The prince sits at the king's right hand. And so, when Jesus takes his place at the right hand of God the Father, he's taking a place of royalty, a place of honor. In the psalm, we say, God mounts his throne. Because Jesus Christ, the second person of the Trinity, is God. And so, he takes his throne. But first, he has to go up. So this celebration, as much as it is focused, I'm calling to mind the conclusion of the Paschal mystery, those four important parts of it, and Christ rising up. We also focus on those words that apply to us, the words that we heard in today's first reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When, after the disciples watched Jesus rise up in glory. Two men dressed in white. What does white represent? Baptism. Two baptized people say to the disciples, "Men of Galilee, why are you looking up at the sky? Get busy." We can't spend our time looking up at a house floating towards Paradise Falls any more than we can spend our time looking up and pondering the mystery of the Lord's ascension. We too are called to get busy. And that very same reading reminds us that it is after the ascension of the Lord that the Holy Spirit comes upon the disciples, upon the apostles, upon the church, and upon us. And we are now in that time, that period of praying for the coming of the Holy Spirit that we will celebrate next week on the Feast of Pentecost, the 50th day after the resurrection. We know that pondering the mystery of the Lord's ascension is a good thing, but spending too much time on it means we're wasting time. The Lord went up with his ascension. The Lord takes his place in glory. We believe that we too will one day rise with him and take our place near his throne. But in the meantime, we have things to do. We will not waste our time looking up at the sky, for soon the Holy Spirit will come upon us, fill us, and send us forth, so that one day we too will go up and find our way eternally to the Lord's Paradise Falls. Chip Farrar, our RCIA coordinator, begins this celebration of the sacraments of initiation.
Will Nicole Campo, one of the elect, who is coming to the waters for baptism, please come forward with your sponsor. Father Bill and members of Christ the Redeemer, I present Nicole for baptism and confirmation.
Has she been found worthy?
After many months of preparation, prayer, and study through the RCIA process, and upon recommendation by her sponsor, instructors, and members of this community, I can testify that she is worthy.
Friends, let us pray to Almighty God for Nicole, who asks for baptism, confirmation, and Eucharist. God has called her and brought her to this moment. May God grant her light and strength to follow Christ with a resolute heart and to profess the faith of the Church. May she receive new life from the Holy Spirit, whom we are about to call down upon the waters of our baptismal font. Let us call to mind the names of those holy men and women who have gone before us in faith as we join together in the Litany of the Saints. Please stand.
Holy Mary, we pray.
This way.
O God, who by invisible power accomplish a wondrous effect through sacramental signs, and who in many ways have prepared water, your creation, to show the grace of baptism, as Christ was washed in the waters of the Jordan River and saw the Spirit descend upon him, we pray. May the power of the Holy Spirit come down through your Son into this font, so that all who have been buried with Christ by baptism into death may rise again to life with him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Nicole Campbell, Tony, your husband and sponsor, people of Christ the Redeemer, through the Paschal mystery that we have celebrated during this Easter season, we have been united to Christ. Now let us renew the promises made on that day of our baptism, along with Nicole, who will join us in professing faith for the first time in the midst of this community. Do you reject sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children?
Thank you.
Do you reject the glamour of evil and refuse to be mastered by sin?
Thank you.
Do you reject Satan, the father of sin and the prince of darkness?
Thank
you. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
Amen.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of the dead, and life everlasting?
Amen.
Nicole, is it your will that you should be baptized in the faith that we have all professed together with you?
Yes.
Then come to the waters of eternal life. Please be seated. Nicole, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Nicole, through the private strength of the Holy Spirit, which you are to receive, you will be made more like Christ, which will help you to be a witness to his suffering, death, resurrection, and ascension. It will strengthen you to be an active member of the church and build us up in faith and in love. Nicole, be sealed with the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Nicole, we present to you this white garment because you have become a new creation, and now you've clothed yourself in Christ. You wear this white baptismal garment. We wear white many times in our Catholic life, first on the day of our baptism. We wear it on the day of our first Eucharist, the confirmation. We wear white even on the day of our funeral. May we wear white proudly until the day Christ comes again. We also share with you the light of Christ from our Easter candle. It is this candle that is brought into a darkened church on the night before Easter as the first part of the Easter vigil, a reminder that it is Christ who is the light of the world. And we now entrust this flame of faith to you. Keep it burning bright forever in your life and in your heart. Amen. Let's welcome the newest member of the church. Let's stand and pray for Nicole, for ourselves, and for the world as we present our petitions.
For wisdom to be witnesses of Jesus. courage to teach everything our Lord has commanded.
Thank you.
may rise up to the heavenly realms. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Shed for you and for many, so that sings me. we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you chose to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by his body and blood, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Joseph, her husband, with the apostles and martyrs, and all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. Lord, may this sacrifice of our reconciliation advance the peace and salvation of all the world. So be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Alan, our bishop, with the order of bishops and all the clergy and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this earthly life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. For there, we too hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to enter into thy presence, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Go in the peace of Christ, alleluia.